one pastor said that what this means is, it's like if you're behind a door and some big, strong, mean, nasty person's on the other side of the door trying to get through, you don't have to beat that guy. You don't have to give him the knockout blow. You don't have to fight him. What you have to do is keep him from opening the door. And God gives you that power. You can keep that door from opening. He's pounding on it. God also gives you the power to open the door and let him in. That's what the resist means here. Resist the devil, and he will flee from you. I'm going to keep going. The next verse. So, come close to God, and God will come close to you. Wash your hands, you sinners, and purify your hearts, for your loyalty is divided between God and the world. Let there be tears for what you've done. Let there be sorrow and deep grief. Let there be sadness instead of laughter, and gloom instead of joy. Let's just get to that last verse. Humble yourselves before the Lord, and he will lift you up in honor. These can be expressed in one phrase. Humble yourself before God. We have to reach out to God. God forgives us, but we need to ask for his forgiveness. Come close to God, and God will come close to you. The communion is for sinners. If you say you aren't a sinner, then you don't have a place in the communion. He says, come close to God. God will come close to you. Our closing hymn is 350. Blessed be the time of Christ. Amen.